Hey guys, summer's almost here, and before this gauge gets way too hot, we want to make sure that we service the HVAC system on the vehicle. Every season, if you're going to go through extreme colds or heat, you want to make sure that your HVAC system works properly. So you can do this easily by making sure that your blower motor for one works. So you want to test in all the speeds. Now if you're only getting speed 5 and you're not getting any of these, there's probably something wrong with the resistor pack. You also want to check and make sure that you're getting every single position working. Does the defogger work properly? Am I getting proper heat control? Do these buttons work over here? Depending on the vehicle that you have, you want to make sure that you have full operation. If you don't, you have to start looking at maybe fuses, actuators, or the control module itself. For your guys' heating system, it could be as simple as just changing out the coolant and making sure that your thermostat works properly. A vehicle that does not get up to operating temperature properly, you're going to have heating issues in the winter. Now for summertime, we want to make sure that our air conditioner works. The air conditioner is obviously important to keep the cabin cool, but it also, in a lot of vehicles like this one, it's crucial for the air conditioner to work so that way our defogger works more efficiently. For the air conditioning system, we want to make sure that the compressor is working. So you see that pulley right down there. It may turn off and on, but you want to make sure that it's actually, see how it's turned off? So it's not going to work all the time, but you want to make sure it actually engages properly. To see what kind of refrigerant that your vehicle uses, you just check under the hood. There's a sticker that you'll see. It'll tell you what type it uses and how much needs to go in. Now we're going to have a professional shop do it because it's not as expensive as you guys think. So we're over here with our friends at Best Transmission and they're going to perform the service for us. So here is the machine that they hook up to the vehicle. And there's two connections that you can see. Now the reason why I'm having a shop do this as opposed to buying a recharge kit at like Canadian Tire or some sort of automotive shop, this actually evacuates all the old refrigerant, and then they can also detect leaks, and then they can put the new one in, and they can also dispose of the old refrigerant properly. So we can actually check how much refrigerant is still left in the system?
Yeah. The machine is gonna take like 15-20 minutes.
So. So right now we're just checking and then we're gonna pull out all the old refrigerant at the same time?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's gonna come up here.
Okay.
After 10-15 minutes.
Okay. So it has to do its thing for a bit.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is how much was in there. How much is supposed to be in there when the truck's new?
Right there. Most cars have it.
Okay, so we were supposed to be at 0.726. We were at 0.515. So not horrible, but it definitely needed to be serviced.
It's down a little bit,
it's
right?
It's down a bit.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever serviced it, though. So it's good that I brought it in.
Yeah.
So on this machine, you have the refrigerant, you have the oil here that lubricates the compressor.
That goes into the compressor and lubricates for the compressor.
Okay.
This is the refrigerant tank.
Okay. So they also add a dye. Most shops will do this, but the good thing about adding the dye is when they service the vehicle over time, they can detect a leak. If there's a leak, they can detect it.
You can detect it with an ultraviolet light.
With an ultraviolet, okay, so you need a UV light to actually detect it.
You need a UV light.
Okay.
Special light.
But that's a nice little trick that you guys do as a professional. That way you can stop problems that become bigger.
Well, you can find out whether it's an O-ring or a gasket.
Very easily.
Or a dryer.
So I'm gonna put a vacuum in the system.
Okay.
This way, we can, after vacuum in the system, and then we're gonna do a leak test same time.
Okay. So is the system empty right now?
Yeah, the system is empty.
Okay.
So we need to put some vacuum in there.
So I don't want to go in and suck.
So with those do-it-yourself kits I can get, do they put an oil in the system too?
No.
Okay. So they do not add any lubricant.
They don't add lubricant.
There's no way to add lubricant to that system.
So people might be topping it off and getting colder air, but they're not adding life to their cooling, to their HVAC system at all.
No.
Okay, so that's one of the biggest things is adding oil to the system.
When you use a proper machine, that's what you get.
So only proper machines like this
will add oil in.
And we'll add the oil.
Yeah. Okay.
So vacuum 15 minutes, and then leak test same time. vacuum the AC refrigerant inside.
Okay.
System.
Oh, so we're refilling it right now.
After this, we'll be refilling.
So first we do the vacuum leak test, and then it refills.
Without
it.
The vacuum, it won't fill up
the
refrigerant.
Okay, we're on to the next step. So it's now doing a vacuum leak test, which is nice with the machine. If the do-it-yourself kit, unless you have, maybe if you had dye in there, just, I don't know how you would test it on a do-it-yourself setup with those little cans that you buy for, you know, 60, 70 bucks. The machine can quickly test the system to see if there's a vacuum leak so we can prevent any future problems that can get bigger and be costly for us. Hey, we passed. So that means the system's all good, no leaks, don't have to replace anything. We can just go ahead and put the new refrigerant in and re-oil it all at the same time. So you have to tell it though each step. It will not continue unless you tell it to.
I can do automatic.
Oh, there. Okay, I see.
But I want to come and see and make sure test actually passed and stuff. So
okay.
Just put it automatic.
You want to know what's going on with it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It makes it easier. So now I just need to charge. Charge the system.
So now we're going to put in the new refrigerant and also the oil all at the same time.
Yeah.
Which the do-it-yourself kits do not re-oil.
No.
So like we discussed before, the only reason to use a refrigerant do-it-yourself is if you're in the middle of nowhere, your kid's in the car, and you need to cool the car down even though you might have a leak. That's like the only reason. Like, we should just be going to a shop for an extra $40.
That's true. This is much better. More. This way you get that oil in the system for lubrication.
And it'll tell you how much oil it's going to add, or is it the same amount every time?
We add in like 10
milliliters. 10 milliliters, okay. Yeah. And this is the part you said, okay, so this part you're putting in the number based on what the vehicle requires. The do-it-yourself kit, people are guessing.
That's true.
They don't know, it's impossible for them to tell how much is going in.
That's good enough.
And then just let it do its thing.
Yeah. And dye, we've got the dye mixing the oil already.
Mm-hmm. So then we can see with the UV light if there's any leaks later on. Yeah.
That's it. This process shouldn't take long. Once we vacuum the system, then this should take 2-3 minutes.
So what would these gauges over here, what are these for?
This is you've got high pressure and low pressure.
Yeah.
So now the high pressure, the low pressure should, when you're doing this right now, it should stay here on the bottom. This way we know there's no leak in the system.
Oh, okay.
And it's good.
So it's good that you can also monitor this with an analog gauge as well. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so we got oil in the system, recharged back to where it needs to be. So that's it? Like, now we can just disconnect?
Yeah, now we just continue. That's it. Now I just have to disconnect. Almost everything.
And there's no way to get those backwards, is there? Like, or can. So those will only go on one way.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes.
So if we're running way below, so we were at 0.726, we measured at like 0.5 something. So if you're at 0.3, let's say, the whole system electronically will work a lot harder as well, because it has to keep going. So the compressor has to keep working.
That's true. It works harder. So sometimes they kill the relay or the fuse.
So we should be at least recharging it on a regular basis to get more life out of it.
Yeah.
Like keeping it full and re-oiled all at the same time. We should be doing this.
It doesn't overheat the electric system. Yeah.
So vehicles that run summertime a lot, we should be doing this maybe 2 to 4 years, we should say, depending on how you use it, to be safe.
Yeah, like 3 to 5,
3 to 5 years would be a good interval time to have this serviced. Okay. Okay, so our HVAC system is now all serviced. Let's actually see how cold it gets. So you see I have it on air conditioning and I am recirculating the air, I'm not letting fresh air in, and I have the temperature all the way down. So let's go ahead and see. So out of this vent, 8.6, so no, getting lower. So I can almost make ice cubes in here. No, I can make ice cubes in here. Let's check the other vent. I'm gonna turn down the fan though. Because we're probably getting a wind chill factor. Let's go over here. What's coming out of the vent? Compressor is engaged right now. This is fan speed one we're testing. I guess with the fan blowing pretty hard, you kind of get like a wind chill factor. So this is what's coming out of the vent at the lowest speed, which it does feel quite cold. That's what matters, is how cold does this thing feel. And this is working really well. And keep in mind guys, this truck is from 2005. So how much did this all cost? Now to put this into perspective, here's a kit they can get from an automotive store. It's $59.99 Canadian. Now keep in mind that this system only tops off the refrigerant. We're not adding any oil to the system, so the compressor does not get any additional lubrication. In theory, if you're only topping off with refrigerant, you're diluting that oil over time, and that oil does need to be changed out every once in a while. Even on my air compressor for work, I change out the oil on a regular basis. There's no reason that you shouldn't be doing it for your AC system. So you can see here, they evacuate and recharge the system. Remember, we're only topping off on these kits. You're not taking the old stuff out. You're just adding in refrigerant. And we're also adding in oil. So it's not that expensive. A lot of people don't get this done at shops because they think it's going to cost them hundreds and hundreds of dollars. It will cost you a few grand, depending on the vehicle that you own. If you have, let's say, the compressor fail or you have to change out parts, for sure it's expensive. But just changing out that refrigerant and adding in oil didn't cost much at all. And that's how much it was after tax. So yes, it does cost more. It's pretty much double, but $130 isn't bad. And my truck's a 2005, just over 200,000 kilometers. I'm gonna get a lot more life out of it because I don't wanna buy a new truck. I just wanna keep servicing mine. And if this is all it costs to do every 3 to 5 years, I'd rather do it this way. As you can see, servicing the system is pretty painless, didn't take long. The machine pretty much does everything for us, but at least the good thing is the machine tells us everything that is happening with the system. It's telling us what we're taking out. We're checking for vacuum, we're checking for any leaks. It's also telling us how much we're putting into the system. Those do-it-yourself charging kits, you guys are kind of guessing. And the biggest thing for me wasn't so much how much refrigerant we're putting in, but the big seller for me was we are lubricating the system by adding oil into it. And you cannot do that on those do-it-yourself kits. And you can see it didn't cost much at all. And I think that's a misconception with getting these things services that it costs a lot of money. What do you guys think? Comment below. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way, at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus, with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section, and it keeps applying it to different vehicles. Yeah.